Anonymous says, people on a long-term low-carb diet with a high protein intake seem to develop, in many cases, a high fasting blood glucose level. This is often explained as a way as adaptive glucose sparing due to the downregulated GLUT expression in muscle. But it seems like the homeostatic set point for blood glucose has changed in these people. Why do you think this is? Well, I mean, when you're probably from low insulin levels, you know, like if you have lower GLUT expression, but you want to get glucose into muscle, you're going to need higher blood glucose levels to do it. Yeah, it's I don't know if glucose sparing is right. I mean, I think if you have lower insulin mediated glucose, GLUT4 expression in adipose and muscle, you're A, going to need more higher levels of blood glucose to get glucose in there, but that's sort of assuming it's a physiologically positive response. You know, you could equivalently say, well, less GLUT4 means you've now, your major major organs that are your major sinks of glucose disposal are now, have now taken a big hit. And so therefore you're glucose intolerant because you can't dispose of glucose as effectively. And that's one way of looking at it as well. I think elevated blood glucose is sufficiently known to be pathological that it would be unwise to assume the sort of more generous interpretation of that as a physiological response. And I think it would be a much better approach to do what you need to do to get your blood glucose levels into the healthy range. Otherwise, I think it's quite a gamble to presume innocence of that elevated blood glucose.